Peach computers. How does that even work? Well, regardless, hello there, ladies and gentlemen. This is Crazy Kitsune Gaming with another episode of the Garden Warfare 2 plant campaign walkthrough. Although I'm not even sure if I should call this episode part of the campaign. So, once you've officially become a leaf agent, then you'll be able to come over to this computer. Once you're all done with all your campaign missions, engage infinity time. So, basically, we are going into the Gnomiverse. Abandon hope, all ye who enter here, for this be the land of gnomes, neither here nor there, nay, not anywhere. So, basically, how this works is you can pay stars to it, and go into the Gnomiverse. Now, the first time you come in here, it doesn't actually cost anything. Now, a thing to note about it is this is basically a endless wave-based mode. There is never any point where there's going to be relief. As soon as you come in here, you're dead. Just full-on warning you. Now, they do let you spend stars to start off at later waves. I actually wouldn't recommend doing that. It's more lucrative to just start at the beginning, which is exactly what we're going to be doing today. Leaf agent status verified. Are you prepared to launch yourself into infinity? Why, yes. Yes, I am. Oh, but first, one more thing to remind you about. Yeah, you thought you escaped this, but nope, I'm here to remind you that if you shoot that button, you'll get a golden gnome over here. Yeah, you thought you escaped. No. I do not give up on my duty to be helpful here on this side of the internet. So, guess we're as ready as we're ever gonna be. Let's go in and get inside the Mechasaurus. Yeah, it does have a bit of a startup period that should be mentioned. All right, off we go. We are about to meet a society that is extremely advanced. The fighting this foe is far more important than any petty political struggle of whether or not humans should be undead or not, or who deserves brains. So here we are. Yeah, this is a bit different than any place we've fought before. And we get to do this mission in a giant dinosaur mech, which, it's a bit of a change of pace. Do not stand in our glorious gnomish gateways! Oh, that's exactly what we're gonna do. Yeah, the people who live here, they don't exactly like visitors. So, before we get into this, I should probably explain how the mech works. So basically, your main attack is the Super Dino Blast, which, keep in mind, does have an overheat. It takes it a very long time to overheat, and its damage is, it's actually really good, but for the enemies we're going up against, it's gonna feel like you're tickling their bollocks. Like, it's just not that effective. Now then, as for your abilities. You have this charge ability, which basically, it's just like any old charge ability. It does a lot of damage, it knocks enemies out of your way, nice and simple. You also have this weird tail spin ability, which I'm pretty sure is kind of like the opposite of the charge attack. It sort of does a tiny amount of damage and pulls enemies towards you. It's kind of an interesting flavor. Now, for the final ability, we have the Epic Mega Blast, which has Epic Mega Energy. So basically, it is an incredibly powerful beam. This is stronger than any Sunbeam, any Gatling Pea. I don't think there's a single weapon in the game that does more damage than that thing. Albeit, it's not the most powerful laser weapon I've seen in games, but like, it's pretty dang effective. Oh yeah, also, you have about 2,000 hit points. Believe me, that will be vanishing quite quickly with the enemies we're going up against. So, yeah. To actually start things off, then you will want to head into this ring, which will increase time stability. Time stability is basically a resource you need to keep yourself in here. Enemies do have ways of lowering it, and if it ever goes empty, then you'll be knocked out. Alright, so yes, once you do that, then you will have this gnome floaty. Most of the floaties are not going to be as pacifist as this one, just warning you. And yeah, as you can see, these things have a ton of health. And when you actually get into the mode proper, they have a large variety of attacks they can send at you. Dang it, I overheated before I even took this thing out. But basically, depending on the side of the face, because as you can see, each of the sides of the floaty has a different looking face, depends on the sort of attacks they'll be sending out. Alright, gnome floaty gone. We are officially in this. Rise, my gnomes! Show them our gnomish ways! So yeah, get prepared for a lot of gnomes. Basically, every single one of these gnomes is going to be as powerful as a hero zombie. Good thing is, a lot of them are very melee focused. But yeah, as you can see, we're doing like hundreds of damage to them before they even blink. Oh, and we got some over here too. Oh, isn't that cute? Oh yeah, and as you're doing this, you'll collect time shards, which can actually heal you up. Oh yeah, and the gnomes do not like it when you take these time shards. Okay, shooty gnomes. Now keep in mind, it can be a good idea to leave the time shards there, because they do kind of act as a certain currency, in a way. But when a few waves are completed, like every couple of waves, you will just automatically collect any time shard that's lying there on the ground. So sometimes it's just a good idea to leave some around for when you start getting really badly damaged, which, believe me, happens very often. Oh, hello. I almost didn't see you back there. Okay. So yeah, all those time shards, I might just leave them there. Our floaties can destabilize time and send you away. Ooh, yes. He's already talking about that. But now we have shieldy gnomes. And, oh, yep, a gnome floaty has appeared. So basically, anytime these guys pop up, they need to be your top priority. In fact, I'm even gonna use some epic mega energy! But basically, they will start destabilizing time, and they also spawn even more gnomes on you. Oh yeah, and shieldy gnomes. Yeah, these guys are a bit annoying. And keep in mind, when you break their shields, they just have a hammer hidden under the shield. So, yeah. Fun times, these shieldy gnomes. Good thing is that their damage potential is very, very low, because unlike shooty gnomes, they don't have a ranged attack. Alright, let's top ourselves off with some time shards. There we go. And this mode will just go on forever. Or at least until you die. Oh yeah, exploding gnomes. So basically, you know the little exploding imps? Yeah, they're basically those on steroids. They're just absolutely, they have found their way into the cat crack. Because they have a lot of health and they do way more damage. Oh, hold on, don't blow up, don't blow up. Ow, okay. At least he only got us with the splat. Okay. Gnomus the Blue can smell you, lo-lo-lo. Oh yes, King Gnomus emerges. Oh, King Gnomus has emerged. So yeah, these are basically the bosses in this area. Oh yeah, and they can destabilize time. The good thing is, with both them and the floaties, they need to charge it up a bit. Alright, let's start getting some good damage on him. Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh yeah, he's got his own rainbow laser. It ain't tickling. Oh, and he just sends. Yeah, he can send out a lot of reinforcements. I think it's kind of based on how much health he has left of when he calls them in. The good thing is, I think when you take him down, the other gnomes tend to go away. Yes, they do. And it's during those gnomus waves when all the shards lying on the ground come to you automatically. You vanquished the king! Ooh, he's an imposter! You have advanced to the green quadrant! Bah! Okay, so yeah. Another thing is they change up the map every once in a while, so now we're in Greenland. Well, not the actual Greenland. I mean, I don't assume Greenland looks anything like this. I hear Greenland is a lot more snowy, and it also doesn't have genocidal gnomes. The art of making ice cubes eludes us, you know. Well, I mean, I'd figure how advanced you are, you would have had that covered. Maybe if you did live in Greenland, you would have had that figured out. Now, I think a lot of the gnomes have different effects to them. Like, I think the blue ones have more... they take a bit less damage. And the green ones definitely have more health. Ooh dear, they're going to summon our most hated enemies. Okay. Where are you going to be doing that from? Oh dear. Tombstone has appeared. Okay, so yeah, zombies. Yeah, been a hot minute since I've seen you guys. Been a bit busy fighting off gnomes who want to take out the both of us. Oh goodness, and super brains. We never even actually saw super brains during the bulk of the campaign. Basically, super brains is an incredibly high damage melee character, and if he gets in your face, yeah, you can expect him to just rip you in half. Like, just no discussion. They also have an ability to jump quite high. And they can also do heroic kicks. Either they should be called villainous kicks. That let the super brains get even closer to you to get that high melee damage. They can also shoot off these super ultra balls, which are... they're not pleasant whatsoever. It is best to avoid getting struck with the super ultra ball. Oh, there we go. Got the engineer with that. Hello, Tombstone. Do you feel like dying? Thank you. Oh, my word. Oh, there's tons. Oh, they're everywhere. Oh, and they have a scientist, too, healing people up. That's just great. Oh, that's just great. I love it when scientists heal away all the damage I've done. Get those guys. Do not need their opinions in this. There we go, get rid of them. They do not have the right to vote on whether or not I live this mission. Out of the way. There we go, clean them up. Out of the way. Oh hey, we got 1,000 coins for completing the bonus objective. Behold! We have manifested the Giga Gnome. Okay, so where are you gonna be sending that out? Okay, over there. So yeah, Giga Gnomes. Interesting little pieces of equipment these guys are. They are basically like the melee gnomes, just like times 200. They also have a very, very powerful laser. Oh yeah, look at that. Ooh, that is not a fun laser to get hit with, let me tell you. And they're quite tanky. Now, I think there's another Giga Gnome somewhere. I could be mistaken. I'm mistaken. Okay, I did not need to use the epic mega laser. But, you know, it was fun to do, either way. Alright then. What are you sending at us next there, King Gnomus? Oh, wow, tons of these guys. Oh, wait, Gnome Floaty, and he's coming straight to home base. Okay. Well, that's unpleasant, because now he's going to be spawning gnomes right on top of us. Don't do that. We don't like having things spawned on top of us. Okay. Let's get rid of them. Okay, good. Oh dear, yeah, that's a big danger when getting rid of the gnome floaties, is you often get surrounded by all the enemies that they spawn. And you can, like, very quickly lose track, and oh, it's just a mess. This entire mode can be a mess sometimes. But so far we haven't come too close to dying. Hopefully I can keep that up. smash. Yeah, that ram does a decent amount of damage, I have to say. Get rid of him. No, I don't want your opinion. Okay. Yeah, see, they're tanky, but, like, they are mortal. And you can dodge their lasers as long as you have cover. With cover, anything is possible. Let's give you another head bonk. Ooh, the head bonk of death it only is. All of the greening ways, Gnomus the Green will stop you! Yeah, I'm sure he'll try. Oh yeah, watch out for the blue orbs of doom. His blue orbs of doom are quite powerful. Not as powerful as his rainbow laser. It's happy fun whoopy whoop time! Oh yes. I shall summon Ultra Commander! Tralala! Oh yeah, oh, ooh yeah! Ooh, these guys are fun! So yeah, tank commanders. But now, they're incredibly massive, and they shoot tons of their little rockets. Yeah, this really shows, like, the power difference when you're in the mech. Usually, that Gargantuar Prime would have been dead, like... Like, he just would have been so much more of a threat. Oh, and General Supremos. Yeah, these guys actually do good damage. We're below half health, actually. Let's get some damage on the Ultra Commander. Oh, they can chuck out so much damage. Good thing is, we can chuck out a little more, can't we? Oh, yes we can, good sir. Yes we can. Where is King Gnome? Okay, there we go. There's Gnomus the Green. Because remember, if you can kill these Gnome Kings themselves, the rest of the wave then becomes invalid. So it can be quite an advantageous thing to focus them down. He's already quite low. Problem is, he's going to try and fight us with all of his allies. Okay, there we go. He is done. 5,000 time shards. We've gotten through 10 waves of this. I wonder how long we can last. This might be a long episode. He was a real... We are too persnickety for you. The Yellow Gnomes will be your undoing. I actually don't know what the Yellow Gnomes do. We have the best singularities in the business. A gnome floaty has appeared. Where it's on top of me again? Do you have no respect? Leave my head alone. Thank you. Time ring stabilized. I mean, they didn't even really have time to destabilize it in the first place. I should actually probably go and Google what the gold gnomes do. Or the yellow gnomes. Because I just don't know what they do. There are also red gnomes. I know they do some extra damage, which can be quite threatening. Ram! Okay, he did go down. I didn't hear the ding. See there, I heard the ding. I didn't hear that when I took out the Giga Gnome. I don't know, maybe that's just a Giga Gnome thing. Oh, he's lasering, he's lasering. I will use your comrade as cover. Ram through you. There we go, that's what we like to do. Okay, he seemed a little confused for a minute about what he was sent here to do. You were sent here to take out the giant mech dinosaur thing. That was your objective. Ooh, yeah, this is a thing to watch out for. As you go through these waves, you will get singularities pop up. And yeah, they do a lot of damage. Gnome floaties, okay. The singularity wants to add his opinion into it, hold on. In my opinion, I do not want this ended early, thank you very much. So I don't know what the singularity is saying, but we're not listening. Here's the problem with floaty attack waves. I quite like using the Mega Awesome Beam, I think that's what it's called, to get rid of the gnome floaties. In the floaty attack waves, they're always going to send multiple, meaning I have to take them on just normally. With all the adds, without the extra damage of the Mega Awesome Beam. Oh, it's just a pain. Good thing is we still do have enough time in the waves now that it can recharge. Oh, we are lasering them down. Oh, we're smacking. We're flapping cheeks out here. Except for the shielding gnomes. We are not fooled by your metal contraptions or your pop music. Hey, I kind of like pop music. I mean, not that much, but like, it's a nice flavor, you know? It's a bit juicy. Oh, another gnome floaty. Are we going to be doing these every wave now? I know you can eventually get to the point, because the waves do get harder over time. You can just get to the point where they send one of these every single wave. It gets exhausting. No, stop destabilizing. Stop destabilizing. Thank you. Oh my god. Oh, they're just surrounding. Oh no. This is the very unpleasant situation you can often get into when dealing with the gnome floaties. I wish I didn't just use my RAM. Could have saved it for now. Okay, now I can use it. RAM. There we go. Perfect. That gets us out of danger and closer to the group of time shards dropped by the floaty. I honestly expected we'd get more health back from that. That was pathetic. I feel like a sunflower could have done more, a whole lot quicker. Okay, overheated the primary weapon again. It is very easy to get caught up with all the combat that you just forget that, oh hey, this weapon overheats, by the way. Did you know? No? Well, too bad. Now you gotta suffer not being able to have it for a long time. Oh no, not another floaty wave. No, I hate the floaties. Where are they even coming from? Where are they even coming? Okay, over there. At least that's one of them. Could I try not using the Mega Awesome Laser this time? I'm just not sure I can be asked, though. It doesn't help that they have all this protection, so, like, it's kind of the best choice to use the Mega Awesome Laser. At least for the first one, where the wave is still early and thick and not very damaged. Where's your next one? Where's your next one? Oh, wow, okay, it's right in front of us. I'm blind, apparently. I am a blind dinosaur. So yeah, that's... Oh no. Okay, that's bad. Oh, I just took two explosions. Completely undefended. That is not ideal. Quick, Mega Awesome Laser! Because I'm not awesome enough to actually kill it any other way! Okay. Come on. Come on. There we go. There we go. Get rid of you. I do not like you. I do like the time shards, though. Could you drop more of those? Hello? Goodbye. These metal contraptions will not protect you from our finery. Meet Gnomus the Yellow. Second Cummus. Cummus? I did not just say that. Anyway, another gnome king is coming, is what he was trying to say. Problem is, we're not starting from a particularly good position on health, or time stability. Good thing is, it does recharge every few waves. Let's try and handle this fight a bit more long term, shall we? He doesn't have any reinforcements yet, that will change. I want to save the laser for when that first group of reinforcements comes, so we can get him out of the fight quicker once that happens. So chill for now, chill for now. Oh, he ain't chilling with the rainbow laser. He loves that rainbow laser. Oh, he has. Oh, he could marry that rainbow laser. And I could marry the Mega Awesome Blast. Okay. He's warping through space and time. He'll be right back. Giga Imp shall squash you! Okay. But the normal imp can't. Let's get rid of the Yeti. Because the thing is, I think these zombie bosses give a sort of disproportionate amount of time shards, which means you can use them to heal. Ooh, yes, that was quite good. Oh my god! Oh, hi, Giga Imp! Oh, and he's a little Drake, too! They're the ones They're the ones that can run around and add fire damage to you. Good thing is he's an imp, so even a Giga one should be quite squishy. Problem is, I'm also squishy at the moment. Well, not now with that all that health they gave me. Oh, and the Drakemex too. Is King Gnomus back? Okay, good, he's back. Except that's also kind of bad. Oh, this could be over. Below 500 hit points. We gotta get that Mega Awesome Laser back. Oh, we gotta get that thing back soon. Let's try and just do some chip damage. Oh, he just really likes those Giga Gnomes. They're his absolute brothers in the combat. Kill him, kill him, kill him, kill him, kill him. Yes! He's gone. Alright, that is another Gnome King dealt with. You actually can get an achievement for taking out all four colors of them. Teehee, you just vanquished another imposter. The Red Realm was freshly painted. Don't touch anything. Wave 16. Wow, they're coming thick and fast. They're just giving you no break. So these ones definitely do extra damage. Even our wealth is wealthy, tra-la-la. What metric are you following? Like, keep in mind, this is a 2024 economy. So, like, what's wealthy to you in your time may not actually be that wealthy anymore. You gotta remember that. Okay, the Giga Gnome always wants to use his laser. Mine's better, though. Yeah, mine's bigger. Oop. And I can actually move with my laser. The good thing about their laser is that they actually slow down when using it. Well, not necessarily a good thing. It's good for you. Okay, do they just have a little mini seizure every time you use the RAM on them? I mean, if so, that just makes the RAM even better, but, like, they never tell you about that. Actually, hold on a sec. They never tell you anything about any of the abilities, I don't think. You just kind of have to go in and figure it out as you go. Ooh, behold your hated enemy. Okay, so we're gonna be having more zombies. But yeah, they just never really tell you about what any of these abilities do in this mode. So I guess it's a really good thing I've made this video, huh? Get rid of them. Get them down. Get them down. The All-Star is so annoying. You're really gonna summon mechs from this thing? Are you joking? No, get rid of that. Oh, there's another one. They're just making these mechs like it's no problem these days. What has the world come to? And a Zen Sensei? Have you no mercy? Get rid of him, and get rid of that tombstone. Yeah, I actually have not played this mode in quite a while. As you can tell by my surprise at the fact that, dear god, they chuck mechs out, no problem. And robot zombies. Oh dear, there's just so much steel being thrown at me. Stop. Okay, laser him, laser him, laser him. Ram. Yes, that gets rid of them. And when I mean RAM, I mean, like, you know, headbutt them, charge them. I'm not talking about random access memory. Although having more of that would be good, even on a dinosaur map. Get rid of the Zen Sensei. There we go. There we go. Perfect. Now get rid of the tombstone. And life is good. Oh, and the Super Brains with his freaking Ultra Ball. No one asked for you. You weren't invited to the party. Oh, what is this about? I don't care about the Super Bowl. Stop shooting me in the buttocks with footballs. Okay, next wave entails more gnomes. I bet there's gonna be a floaty here at some point. I'm psychic! Where is it? There. Kill it. Destroy it now! Okay, there we go. Now I'm actually gonna end the Epic Mega Blast early so that it recharges quicker. That probably seems like a backward strategy because I'm missing out on damage, but it'll be helpful later. Because I know there's gonna be another gnome floating. Well, actually, no, this isn't a... It's not even a floaty attack wave, so I'm perfectly fine. You just kind of get to the point, eventually, where, like, gnome floaties are a very normal occurrence. Oh, dear. Yeah, it's always such an interesting situation when you have two of the Giga Gnomes on you. Because that's just so many hit points you gotta chew through. I have cover. I could take them out both with a charge. Let's try it. Oh my, it actually did. That actually just got rid of them. Man, I love it when my plans work. Sorry, that was a stretch. We've been going on for quite a while now, I must say. Wave 19. I wonder, are we gonna get another gnome floaty? No, stop with the laser. No one likes the laser. Sorry to any, like, laser fans out there, but I don't like getting hit with it. Oh dear, okay. Well, that charge put me in an awkward position. Oh my word. Oh my word. Oh no, not double laser. Oh, I hate double laser. That's my least favorite item on the menu. Pack it in with the double laser. It's just not popular. The charge is, though. Wow, they just have so many. We're getting to the point now where, like, the hammer gnomes aren't as deadly as the shooty gnomes. So, thereby, the shooty gnomes become more common. He who has red will redden you. That's a very interesting way of saying he's gonna kill me. You shall see about it. Where are you going? Oh, you're trying to destabilize the timering over there. Okay, yeah, that's one thing I forgot to mention, is that the ability for them to destabilize time is only in very specific spots. So if you can keep them out of those spots, then that can be quite advantageous. Where do you get these rainbow lasers from? What kind of level attack have you reached? Okay, we got a epic mega laser him now. Get him out. Get him out. Okay, he's warping. Who has he spawned to save him? Cosmic Mayhem. Oh dear, so it's a massive cosmic brains. Ooh, I see where he is. Now, just so you know, whatever super zombie they spawn in, if you kill him, then King Gnomus will come back immediately after that. So just keep that in mind for when you're trying to get yourself out of a tight spot. You know what's funny? I think the extra damage isn't actually helping them. Because the thing is, the blue and green ones, I'm pretty sure, have more health and damage reduction, which means they end up dying faster. Well, dying slower, I should say. But the red ones don't have that, they just deal more damage. And I think it's actually not as effective as extra health. Okay, Zen-sensei. Just... Oh, really? With the clones too? That's just an insult. Hey, where have you been, buddy? You let Zen-sensei die all by himself. Honestly, they should call you coward brains. Oh dear, he spawned allies. Get rid of him. There we go. Oh dear. Yeah, cosmic brains normally aren't very threatening. When you make them as big as a skyscraper, though, bit of a different story, isn't it? Where are you going? This is the most cowardly super brains I've ever seen. Where is... There he is. Destroy him. Terminate him. And the dirt is gone. Bosh. You vanquished the king! No, wait, just an imposter. So you've reached the Rainbow Realm.
Lo.
So yeah, now we're gonna have all the different types of gnomes attacking us. Also, King Gnomus just said it, but the gnomes, the singularities that start spawning, the gnomes aren't affected by those. They just do not care. Gnomes enjoy a good game of infinite tennis. Most matches never end. Yeah, just like this mode. Oh, wow, okay, that is a horrible start. Oh, I hate myself for that. Oh, I just let myself take so much damage so fast. Okay, no, we gotta save this somehow. Ooh, and the red singularity's out. Hold up. Okay, he's gone. I don't need you chipping away at my health anymore. I've already been devastated. Lost over half my health in the first wave of this area. Freaking pathetic. But yeah, by the way, if you walk into those singularities, you just end up dying. Like, incredibly quick. Okay, Nemesis Wave. So where are you sending them? Where are they starting off at? Obviously not nearby. Okay, over there. That's the first one. Oh, can I shoot the... Oh, I can shoot the top of it from over here. Ooh, that's nice and sneaky. That didn't stop them from getting out of Disco Zombie. Oh yeah, and apparently the summoned zombies, they're also immune to singularities. Yeah, that's a bucket of fun, isn't it? Alright, making our way to the next tombstone. Or actually, there's one over here. I need to be so elaborate. Alright, start dealing damage to it. Okay, they're dishing out a whole lot of damage. Get rid of... I didn't kill any of them? What? None of them died. They just got out of that ram. Just, no. Who gave you a guilt-free brownie? Get rid of Disco Zombie. He's gonna give us a lot of health. Good. Oh, there's a Goat Gantuar! I didn't even know you could appear here! It's been a hot minute, hasn't it, buddy? It's been the Rose mission since I had to fight you. Oh, I'm just not killing anything. I'm doing these, like, drive-by attacks, and it's just not enough. Oh, and the green singularity is here, too. Freaking tombstone defended by a singularity. What kind of BS is that? Out of the way. Out of the way, everyone.
Nope.
Time itself cannot defeat us, so how could you? I can't. I literally can't. Wave 27. Is there gonna be a gnome floaty?
Ooh, my spidey senses got it.
Oh dear, he's doing the weird beam thing. Stop with the weird beam. Okay. Use this. No, you guys can't. Your opinion is not allowed. Quiet. Hush, child gnome! Weird ankle biter! I was kind of hoping to not get hit by all that. I am really low on health. This is real. I have not played this well whatsoever. If I can kill this guy, I can get some health back. But the other one's coming right behind him, isn't he? Yep, no privacy. There we go. I think we're alone now. I'm gonna ring when no one else is around. Okay, hold on. Ooh, is this dodgeable? No, he was just lasering my buttocks that entire time. Good thing is, he is almost out of here. Almost. Boom. Gone. Can we at least get over 1,000 hit points? Yes? Okay. Singularity, sawed off. I do not want to go on a date with a singularity right now. Oh no, another floaty attack. This one could be quite close, actually, because I'm not starting with a decent amount of health. Okay, at least it's starting nearby, so I can destroy it quite quickly. Oh, not with the blue laser eyes. Don't do that. Okay. Get that thing recharging early. Let's grab some hit points. Okay. Grab that little chunk of health. Perfect. We're out of the red. Okay. He is unfortunately destabilizing. He's kind of going to get a lot of damage in. Yeah, he's spawned in a great spot. Ring around the rosy. Fox kills the floaty. There we go. Mega awesome blast it. Or no, it's the epic mega blast. My apologies. I would not want to offend anyone by getting this thing's name wrong. Okay, two Giganomes. And two singularities just chomping at the bit to eat me up. Nope, that's why cover exists. That's what it's made for. And you're gonna use your shielding gnome as cover, okay. Well, to each their own. Ram through it, because the ram does actually, yeah, that means he misses out on a lot of his damage potential. Okay, hold on. There we go, one of them down. Give you a bonk. Ooh, that's what we'd like to see. How much damage did that deal? I'm not entirely sure. I think it said like 400. I just know I saw a lot of zeros. Okay, that was bad. Did not want him bashing me. We are timeless. Timey time timeless. Gnomus, the king is here to show you his colors. Okay. The gnome king emerges and he's got two freaking... How are you gonna come in here with two singularities? Oh yeah, by the way, the singularities actually eat up your lasers. Yeah. Annoying. Stop destabilizing. That's not cool. Destabilizing time was so last year. You just gotta get with the times. Oh yeah, and his rainbow beam is quite dangerous. I actually kind of want to save the Mega Epic Blast for when he calls in his reinforcements, particularly that special zombie boss. Okay, he has the reinforcements. Maybe it's better to kill this stage of the reinforcements so that the zombie boss has less health? I'm not sure. I just know I don't want to use the Mega Blazer right now. I want to save it for the zombie boss. Good thing is there are time shards lying around. See, I told you leaving these things was a good strategy. Okay, where's the zombie boss? It is a cosmic brains. A cosmic mayhem brains, I should say. Okay. There's a second, no! There's a second one? Are you bollocks? Okay, go, go, go. Ooh, I did not expect that. A scientist healing a Giganome. Oh my, that's disgusting. I'm gonna vomit into my underwear and then elbow drop it. That's how disgusting that was. How are you gonna have a scientist running in here and healing a freaking Giganome? That is just so extra. Okay, well, we know one mega awesome laser is enough to completely eradicate this guy. Baron Bombats, no, just no. No, no. No one asked. I've maxed out my render distance and I still can't find the guy who's asked for the freaking Baron Bombats. Okay, get rid of Oh, he almost hit me that one. Oh, wow, okay, you just appear right in front of my face. Okay, how gentlemanly. Ram. Boom. How'd you like that? Apparently he doesn't care about that. He's still alive. Oh, but he definitely cared about that.
All right.
45 waves of this stuff down. You vanquished the king! No, wait, just an imposter. You guys sure have a lot of imposters. Can you really handle the blueness? Yes, so now we are back to the realm of blue. Although now it's dark blue. And I think the gnomes actually have a bit more damage reduction because of it. So apparently the darker your blue, the better. After the third in infinity, the gnomes got bored. I'm glad to know. No. You are not allowed there, Mr. Red Singularity. Okay. Oh, yeah. The Mega Epic Blast does splash damage. So if you have two of the Giga Gnomes side by side, you can actually get rid of them both. Interesting development. I never thought about using it that way. Okay, next wave in 5 seconds. Hup, hup, hup! We summon your most hated enemies! Alright. Where are you doing it from? Not there. Then where? Is it over here? Oh, over there, okay. Mega Blast in time! Ooh, and we're getting some of the Gargs too. There we go. Get rid of the Garg. Are you just immune to laser fire? What was that? I swear I didn't see numbers popping up just then. That is some bollocks, I'll tell you what. Let's get rid of the Giga Garg. There we go. Get some health back. That's what we like to see. We don't like to see pirates. Or engineers trying to stun us. Oh, there's quite a few of you. Super Brains, I don't like you. I could make an entire rant video about how overpowered you are. Don't get involved, buddy. Okay. Now, could I theoretically save the last of this epic mega energy? Because you do walk slower while using this, but this one's real close. So, yep, that's what we're doing. Call Baron Bomb, that's more none of that beam. Okay, does the ram not hurt the tombstone? If so, that kind of sucks. No, don't. Oh, now he's summoning the teenage vampire zombies. Don't do that. I hate the emo teenage vampire zombies. They're so yesteryear. Okay, so now thankfully it's just a case of getting rid of the last of these stragglers. Okay, let's finish this off with style. Your barrel is not going to save you. Oh really, he summoned in another swarm. No, not allowed. We use the galaxy as a cushion protector. Yeah, like I said, this is a very advanced society. But apparently their military weapons aren't very advanced. Seeing as we've gone through 28 waves of this. Although it could be coming to a close. Rather soon. Especially if I'm gonna laser a gnome floaty and it just does no damage. What was that about? Okay. Mega Epic Blast it. Actually, Epic Mega Blast it. There we go. Okay, now stop it. That way the ability will come on recharge sooner. Get rid of the explodey guys, first things first. Where is that other floaty? Is it a floaty attack wave? No, it's not. Okay. They only seem to send multiples during the floaty attack waves. You can hand it in with that laser rifle, I'll tell you what. Mm-mm. Nope, that's not happening. I already told you, I don't like the mega laser. Don't make me repeat myself. Okay, hold on. Oh dear. They love the double like mega laser. But I love the RAM. And the RAM is better than the laser. Did you not know? Okay. Oh boy, 29 waves. Wow. We've been here a while, haven't we? Yeah, Gnomus ain't doing a great job of kicking us out, that's for sure. With the singularity freaking sandbagging. Oh, he's protecting the entire squad. That's just no. No, that's rude. It's a clever strategy, but it is very rude. Okay. Epic Mega Blast him. Get rid of the sponges in front of us. That's honestly what they feel like sometimes. They are just damage sponges. Who also double as something that can deal damage. There we go. Get behind the rock. Haha, you've been foiled by nothing but a rock. How does that feel? Makes you feel not so mega epic awesome, does it? Gnomus the Blue will crush you with his blueness. Okay, Gnomus the Blue again. Okay, hold on. He likes his blue balls of death. Wait, no, there's two of them. Oh, right, yeah. Once you've defeated the Rainbow Gnome King, then they start sending multiples of the kings. So we want to epic mega laser you down straight away. I forget how the health works when there's more than one king. Well, either way, he's about dead. Can we make him dead? Okay, one king down. Wow, they do not give a whole lot of time shards, do they? Yeah, I expected a bit more health, huh? Oh, really? He's off to stabilizing again. No, stop that. You shall join your comrades in the field of battle. Stabilizing, tis a cowardly way to win a battle. And so is an epic mega blast to the face. But you know what? You were the coward first, so I have full permission to do this. Oh, that's a lot of reinforcements. Okay. Huh. Okay, I just need to, like, sit down and relax just a few seconds. Oh my goodness. Of all the greens, I like this green the best. Okay. Alright, so, there's another singularity out there, isn't there? Oh, and plenty more green gnomes. Yeah, they feel more tanky. I'm not entirely sure. I could be wrong on what each of the gnome colors does. You don't tend to fight a lot of gnomes in this game. Do they scream each time you hit them? They kind of do, just a little bit. Okay, that kind of makes me sad. But then I remember they're gnomes that... Oh! Got a taste of that singularity. At least the red one does the least damage. They really like the twin giganome thing. I say, I like my blazer. I've ran out of lines at this point. I am empty on jokes to make. How long we've been sitting here? Almost an hour! I did not realize that's how long I was out here. How many gnomes have I gotten? 382. Okay. Okay, there's our first gnome party. We shall foil the floaty. Oh, wait, no, the floaty's summoning a giganome. Hold on, trouble. Trouble! There we go. Kill him! Kill him! Okay, they're all gotten rid of now. Where is the floaty? There! Okay. ram his little protectors. We do not have the time nor the patience to deal with them. We're just lasering his buttocks all day and all night. There we go, epic mega blast. Now we shall... Oh no, it's gonna end to a singular! Oh no, okay. Yep, yellow singular. That's why you don't run into the singularities. They bite! Okay, the good thing is... Yes, okay, we can get back in this. Ooh, yes we can, okay. We have a little sliver of health left. Yeah, those singularities are painful. They both eat up your damage and damage you if you walk inside them. Not pretty. Oh, hold on. Okay. Yeah, thing is, now there's, I think, three of them out here. Yeah, it's the whole party. Oh, look at that. It's a little family of singularities. I'm absolutely horrified. We need to get out of this general area real quick. Hopefully they don't call in another floaty. As I say that, boom, gnome floaty has appeared. Okay. Well, we gotta be having to do something about that. I might just die. This may be the furthest I've ever gotten. I don't think I've ever gotten past, like, the blue waves. Well, like, the secondary blue waves. Okay, blast it. Have half of it get eaten up. I think we're going downhill. Because there may be another floaty. I might die regardless of secondary floaty. I don't think there's just enough time shards. Oh yeah, we would need way more than that. And we don't need the singularities adding to our opinion. Might need some guerrilla warfare at this point. But I just don't have any cornfields. I don't have much cover. Well, it's been a run, that's for sure. Okay, now could I do something where like ram into hit points? Yes! I'm dead anyway, but yeah! Okay, there we go. Got rid of him. Oh, he's just not going down. He ain't going down. Let me check on my recording software real quick. Yeah, it's still recording. I would have crashed by now if I was a recording software. There are so many colors. Okay, another nemesis wave. Good thing is, these things are actually kind of okay for getting some hit points back. If you can kill them quick enough. Like that, just killing the zombies like that, that's quite healthy. Okay, one down. We're over 1,000 again. That's gonna change now because we have freaking Burn Von Bats! Okay. Get some chip damage in on the tombstone. Burn Bombats, get out of here. No one invited you. Oh, but, okay. I might have invited that guy to the party. He does seem like the kind of guy who likes his pizza, so I might have invited him. But, I'm sorry, I've already eaten all the pizza. You have to go now. Okay, we're back up to a decent amount of health. It ain't over yet. We are still a thing which exists. We might not be if we can't get to this tombstone in time. Hold up, I'm coming. Oh, hello guys. Oh, they had this nice little blockade for me when I got here. That's so cute. That's so adorable. Smash all that. Pirate, what are you doing? That's not gonna kill anyone. Not with the type of tech we're talking now. Okay, mega awesome laser it, especially now that there's a Garg here. Okay, objective complete. Oh, you dare breathe the same air as the gnomes? Gnomus the Green awaits. Hello there, Gnomus the Green. I heard you had some free real estate on those time shards. Could I have some? Oh, wait, hold on. Oh, Greenie's brother is trying to destabilize something, I can tell. Yep. I knew that ring was there. I had you covered. Perfect. Okay. Now let's start lasering these guys down. Gnome reinforcements! Okay. Remember, as long as you can kill the kings... Uh-oh, okay, they're warping now. They're warping again! Oh, what are they summoning? Ultra Commanders! Okay. This could be it. Oh, I just ate so much laser fire. That is not healthy. Because now we get to fight both a king and a zombie boss. Smash into him. Good. Great. Not perfect, though. Not enough of them actually died in that. Is the problem. I know if I can get the Ultra Commander dead, though. I know that tends to give a lot of hit points. Of course, Gargantuan Prime also gives plenty. Okay. Not quite the Ultra Commander dead, but we're getting it. We are getting there. Get some damage on him, get some damage on him. Oh, he's quite tanky. Oh, he has tons of hit points. Okay. Not ideal. Wait, who's doing... No. Stop that. Stop. No, not more reinforcements. I'm not even done with the Ultra Commander. Oh, there's just so much at this point. There's just so much to think about. You got the singularities, you got the fact you're fighting gnomes and zombies at once. That's a bit extra. Oh, and you got King Gnome is tanking everything for the Ultra Commander! Stop! Okay, hold on, we got back out. Dang it. Not good. I want to kill that Ultra Commander right then and there. Okay. Back in the running, kind of. General Supremos are putting us out of the running. Okay. Two King Gnomes at once. Not ideal. Both of them are so squishy, though. It's doable. It is doable. Stop the laser. I don't like the laser. That's the last thing I want right now. Okay. One gnome ki- Oh, they're both here. Kill one, kill one, kill one. Good. Oh, that's just- Oh. That warrants more zombie reinforcements. Another Ultra Commander. Okay. We have some distance, though. It's gonna be a while before they can actually get into the fight. I don't know where you came from. But thank you for the extra 50 hit points. This may be the furthest I've ever gone in Infinity Time. Not gonna lie to you. Gotta keep in mind the Red Singularity. And apparently Baron Bombats has an opinion as well. Well, my opinion, I deserve 50 more hit points. So what do you think about that, huh? What's your argument against it? I've killed the zombies. I've earned these hit points. Now I've overheated. Okay, never mind. You have a valid argument. Okay, got rid of those two? Good. We take that. Mega blast them. There we go. Lots of hit points there. We can bring him down. Bring him- No! Don't do that. Do Do not make me waste the epic mega energy. It's too valuable. Okay. Please give me time shards. Thank you. Okay. We just gotta bring him down. Problem is, I just spunked the epic mega laser. Not ideal. I also overheated. Oh my word. Oh my. Oh no, 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 no. Do not. Don't you dare. Don't you dare. Bad singularity. Oh my god. Okay. Where are we going next? Oh dear, back to yellow. Oh my word. Foo foo foo! You reached the yellow! Shame on you. Well, no, shame on you. You're the one who let me get this far. Summoning multiple gnome kings at once, and you still can't take me out of here. I'm gonna be honest, this is a new record for me. Never before have I reached these heights. Okay, and I think I may have flown a bit too close to the sun. Yep, that's what a yellow singularity does to you. Yeah, destroying you. They tend to do that. That's kind of a shameful way to end it. Okay, so now that we're through all that... You take, we take back! Remember, we are the rulers of time! So yes, when you've finished this all, then all of your time shards will go into that chest. And depending on how many you got, it will continue upgrading the chest. This is also a place where you can get certain party variants of characters. So yeah, keep that in mind. Alright, amazing twiddle chest. Do we get one more upgrade? Infinite infinity chest. All right. Quite a stylish looking chest. Oh god, I need to just... I mean, I'm knackered. Let's open her up. You haven't heard the last of us, or the first. 20,000 coins. Okay. But yeah, keep in mind, you can get... the infinity characters. Not the infinity characters, the party characters from Infinity Time. And they tend to be basically completely better variants of what the original character is. So, wave 35 completed. Or waves completed 35. That is a lot of time shards. And almost as many coins. I think I can buy another classic item from Rux now. Definitely gonna be doing that. So, yeah. Man, what a campaign. We've taken out less than 1,000 robot zombies. We've handled nuclear weapons. We've helped out lazy roses that can't fight for themselves. We've been to volcanic areas. We've helped out scout units. Oh my word. But now we are finally completely done with the campaign. So, now... that you are officially a Leaf Agent, then you'll be having much more freedom in your future engagements with the zombies. Because despite all we've done, there is still more of them to put back in the grave. So, next I will be showing you some of the wonderful ways you can do that. But until then seriously, please, subscribe, like, comment, share it with your friends. All that good stuff, because oh my word. We've been sitting here an hour. This might be like the longest PVZ video ever. And it's just for the fact that I survived so long. So, yeah. Reaching new heights every day. So, I will see you next time. Until then, have a good day. And don't let the gnome bugs bite.